Good afternoon, children. We are in the last topic of the democratic politics, that is the outcomes of the democracy. Let us see how do we assess democracy's outcomes. Outcomes means it is nothing but the what are the results of the democracy. Let us see in detail about it. So here, do you remember how students in Madam Lindock's class argued about the democracy? This was in chapter 2 of the class 9 textbook. It emerged from that conversation that democracy is a better form of government when compared with a dictatorship or any other alternative. We felt that democracy was better because it promotes equality among the citizens. Very important point, underline it. What does democracy do? It promotes equality among the citizens. Because of democracy, we feel that all the citizens who are living in our country are equal. Both men and women are equal. Enhances the dignity of the individual. Yes, very important. It enhances the dignity of the labor. It enhances the dignity of the individual. It enhances the dignity of the employees. It enhances the dignity of the people who are living in our country. Dignity means the self-respect is enhanced. It is boosted in the democracy. Improves the quality of decision making. Yes, the decision making, it improves the quality of the decision making. Why? Because what will happen when we are talking about the democracy, here everyone has agreed to the decision what they have made. So what happens it in the democracy? Here it is clear that with everyone's interest point of view, everyone's opinion only, the decision has been put forth or the decision has been taken in the country. Provides a method to resolve the conflicts. To resolve the conflicts means whatever the fights, whatever the disputes that has been happened in our country, it has been solved. It provides a method to resolve everything, each and everything in our country. Resolve the conflicts, the fights between the people. Allows room to correct mistakes. So whatever the things are there, it allows the room to correct mistakes. So whatever the mistakes it is made, it should be corrected by whom? By the representatives, MPs. Whatever the, if they make a wrong decision, there is a room for correction. Again, the law can be changed. Again, it can be amended in our constitution. So it creates the room to correct our mistakes. Are these expectations realized under democracies? When we talk to people around us, most of them support democracy against other alternatives such as rule by monarchy, a monarch or military or religious leaders. So rule by the religious leaders or the rule by the kings, rule by the military people, that is not there in the democracy. But not so many of them would be satisfied with the democracy in practice. So if we face a dilemma, democracy is seen to be good in principle but felt to be not so good in its practice. So what is happening here in the democracy? Some people find it a dilemma. Some people views it is not at all completely expressed in the democracy. But as it is, they are telling that to hear that it, as a principle it is good. But in the practice, it is not so good. But it is not like that. So it is good. When the practice, you can see, because of democracy, we are enjoying all the freedom, right? You have got all, there is an equality between the men and women. We are free to practice any religion. We are free to follow anything. We are free to do anything in our country. Unless and until it is legal, not illegal things, right? Legal things, whatever is there, you can do in our country. Right, this dilemma invites us to think hard about the outcomes of the democracy. Do we prefer only for normal reason or there are prudential reason to support democracy too? So let us see what are the reasons which supports prudential reasons. Prudential means the correct reasons to support the democracy. Let us see. Over 100 countries of the world today claim and practice some kind of democratic politics. They have formal constitutions, they hold elections, they have parties and guarantee rights of the citizens. So over 100 of years, 100 countries, over 100 countries of the world today claim and practice what? Some kind of the democratic politics. That is, they have formal constitutions, means the constitution which are legally organized, that constitutions they are having. They hold elections, yes, in the democracy. You are seeing in our country what we do, we hold or we have the elections in our country, we hold the elections. They have parties and they guarantee rights of the citizens. Yes, we have the parties in our country, different types of parties. You are seeing Congress party, BJP party, Janata Dal, Bharatiya Bahujan Samaj party, like this we are having so many parties in our country. And what it guarantees? It guarantees the rights of the citizens. While these features are common to most of them, these democracies are very much different from each other in terms of their social situations, their economic achievements and cultures. So what happens here with these all the features common to most of them, these democracies are very much different from each other in terms of their social situations, their economic achievements and their cultures. So they are different. There may be the social systems may be different, the social situations may be different, their economic achievements may be different, their cultures, whatever is there in India, it is different. Clearly, what may be achieved or not achieved under each of these democracies will be different. But is there something that we expect from every democracy just because it is democracy? So there are, clearly we can see that there are some things which we can accept in the democracy. Let us see what are these things. Our interest in and fascination for democracy often pushes us into taking a position that a democracy can address all socio-economic and political problems. So our interest in the democracy often pushes us to think about the position that a democracy is holding in what? In the socio-economic and related to the political problems of our country, right? If some of our expectations are not met, we start blaming the idea of the democracy. Yes, there is always the socio-inequality will always be there. There will be in a country, there will be rich class, middle class, poor class. It will be definitely there, will be there in any country. It cannot change, right? Even though there is a democracy, we cannot say that it will be changed over the years, because how many number of population is there in our country? It is 130 crores population is there in our country. Do you think the changes will happen within the 2 days or within the 3 days? It is not possible. We cannot do the magic. It takes lot of time. It takes much of time to change the things in the democracy. And political problems, yes, it is going to happen because there are so many parties. In the last year you have studied, there are 750 parties in India. Then there will be political problems. The MLAs start moving from one party to the another. And MPs, you have seen, that is called as a defection. They start moving, they start changing their parties in the democracy. Are we start doubting if we are living in a democracy? The first step towards thinking carefully about the countries of democracy is to recognize that democracy is just a form of government. Yes, it is just a form of government. It is just a government. It can only create conditions for achieving something. Yes, it creates lot of conditions, right? We can, any person, any citizen of the country can achieve something, because when you are given the freedom to work, when you are given the freedom to speech, when you are given the freedom, education rights are given to you, that time what you can do so many things. The citizens have to take the advantage of those conditions and achieve those goals. So the citizen has to take lot of advantages of those conditions, and they are forced to achieve those goals. Let us see how it is possible. It is accountable, responsive and legitimate government. So how it is the outcomes of the democracy in that? The second point here it is the government is accountable, it is responsive and it is legitimate government. Legitimate government means it is a legal government, right? Here in the cartoon you can see what it knows about you. Here you can see what it knows about you. In the microscope, this is the government, he is analyzing the things, what really people want from you. So now let us see, there are something that democracy must provide. Yes, everyone has one or the other wish, everyone has some or the other needs, everyone has some or the other demands, that should be fulfilled by whom? By the democracy. In a democracy, we are concerned with ensuring that people will have the right to choose their rules and people will have control over the rulers. Yes, they have the right to choose the people as their representative. They have the right to choose the MLA of the country. They have right to choose the MP of the country. And the people who are ruling them, they have the right to choose. If they are not ruling according to the people, according to the needs of the people, according to the wishes of the people, next year they can see that party doesn't form the government, that person doesn't win in the election. Whenever possible and necessary, citizens should be able to participate in decision making that affects them all. Yes, it is the citizens' duty to participate in decision making process. You can see the Bengalurians, they never come outside the home during the elections. In the election day, when the election day is announced, when the people come for voting, they think that it is a holiday and they sleep at home. You can see in the media, they are calling them and they are telling them, come outside your home and vote, right? So many brand ambassadors they will do in order to enhance, in order to boost the people, in order to motivate the people to come and vote. So people's duty it is to participate in the decision making that affects them all. It is not that the decision making is going to affect only one person in the country. It is going to affect them also. So it is our duty, both educated and uneducated citizens, it is our duty to select a proper candidate, to see that the correct candidate wins in the election. Therefore, the most basic outcome of the democracy should be that it produces a government that is accountable to the citizens and responsive to the needs and expectations of the citizens. Yes, very important, it is accountable. Right, each and every MLA of the constituency is accountable whom? To the people of his constituency. He is responsible for that. ಇಲ್ಲೇನ್ರ ಮುದೋಣ ಕೆಲಸ ಆಗಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಬೈತೀರಿ? ಕಾರ್ಜೋಳ ಸಾಹೇಬ್ರಿಗೆ ಬೈತಿರಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲರ ಸೇರಿ. ಏ ರೋಡ್ ಸರಿ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ, ನೀರಿನ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಬೈತಿರಿಲ್ಲೋ? ಸೊ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್? ದ MLA ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯುವೆನ್ಸಿ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್. ಸೊ ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟೇಬಲ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟು ಮೀಟ್ ದ ನೀಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೂಮ್? ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಿಟಿಸನ್ಸ್. Before we go into this question, we face another common question. Is the democratic government efficient? Is it effective? Very important. Whatever we do, it should become efficient as well as effective. ಹೌದಿಲ್ರಿ? ಅಂದರೆ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೂ ಏನಿರ್ತದೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ನಾವು ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಕೆಲಸ ಏನಿರಬೇಕು ರೀ? ಎಫಿಷಿಯೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿಯೂ ಇರಬೇಕು ಮತ್ತು ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿಯೂ ಇರಬೇಕು. Some people think that democracy produces less effective government. People are thinking that democracy is producing what? Less effective government. It is of course true that non-democratic rulers do not have bother about a deliberation in assemblies or worry about the majorities and public opinion. Yes, in the dictatorship of form of government, what do we see? The only leader is taking the decision. He is not concerning about what majority of the people think. What are their opinions about it? What are the things about it? So what happens? They are not taking the public opinion. So sometimes we feel that it is effective. So they can be very quick and efficient in decision making and implementation. So what we feel that, yes, that is good and it will be become very effective and implementation of the decision making becomes very easy. Democracy is based on the idea of deliberation and negotiation. So democracy is based on what idea? On the deliberation and the negotiation. Negotiation means what? Talking, on the discussions it is based on. So some delay is bound to take place. Does that makes democratic government inefficient? Does it going to make the democratic government inefficient? Let us see. Let us think in terms of cost. Imagine a government that may take decisions very fast, but it may take the decisions that are not accepted by the people and may therefore face the problems. Yes, if you take any decision in fast, then what will happen? That will not be accepted. If it is not accepted by the people, then what is happened? The government has to face lot of problems. So before taking the decision, collect the opinion of the people. Take the advice of the people and then make the decisions. Otherwise, what will happen? You have to face a lot of problems. So for example, Yedurappa ji, en madidri? Yedurappa avaru en madidru? Bada bada en madra? Driving license compulsory. Right, all the papers of the bike and all, it is compulsory. Insurance is compulsory, like that he did. And what happened when the law was passed and it, when it was implemented on the roads, people started complaining about it. Then slowly what they did? They started losing the rules. They started what? Making the rules as simple as possible. They gave a lot of concessions in the rules. So this thing will happen if you take the immediate decision without the concern of the people. But because it has followed procedures, its decisions may be both more acceptable to the people and more effective. So if it is following the procedures, then it will happen, its decision may become both more acceptable to the people and also it will become more effective to the people. So the cost of time that democracy pays, it perhaps worth it. So whatever the cost goes in concerning the different kinds of people, types of people, it is good. It is not at all a burden because we have considered, we have taken the advice, we have considered the opinions of the different people in our country. It will become a people's decision rather than a MLA decision or a MP decision. Now look at the other side. A democracy ensures that decision making will be based on norms and procedures. So decision making will be based on what? On the rules and regulations, norms and procedures. And then rules and regulations mele democracy is based. It is not that whatever we do, it is a democracy. It is good in democracy or it is legal in democracy. Not like that. ನೀವು ರಸ್ತೆ ಒಳಗೆ ನಿಂತು ಸ್ಮೋಕಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗುಡ್. ವೇರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವೇರ್ ನೋ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡೂ ದ ಸ್ಮೋಕಿಂಗ್ ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಜನರ ಗುಂಪು ಇರ್ತೈತಿ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಸ್ತಮ ಪೇಷಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಥರ ಪೇಷಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ನೀವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ನಾಗ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸ್ಮೋಕಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಲೌಡ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಡೆಮೊಕ್ರಸಿ ನಾವು ಏನು ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ರೀ, ಹೆಂಗೆ ಬೇಕು ಹಂಗೆ ಇರ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫಾಲೋ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡೆಮೊಕ್ರಸಿ. So a citizen who wants to know if a decision was taken through the correct procedures can find this out. She has the right and the means to examine the process of decision making. So she has the rights and what? And the means to examine the process. Here every citizen has the right. He can examine the process of decision making, how the decision making has been taken in the democracy. This is known as transparency. Yes, in our country we have one factor called the transparency, where you can see how the decision has been taken in the government. This factor is often missing from a non-democratic government. Yes, this factor is always missing where in a non-democratic government, because it will be the decision taken by only one person, not by the all the public opinion. It is not a public opinion, but it is a decision taken by only one person. Therefore, when we are trying to find out the outcomes of democracy, it is right to expect a democracy to produce a government that follows procedures and is accountable to the people. This is most important. Whatever the rules we are following, whatever the procedures we are following, it should be accountable to the government or accountable to the people. We can also expect that the democratic government develops mechanisms for citizens to hold the government accountable and mechanisms for citizens to take part in the decision making whenever they think fit. So whenever you are going to take the decisions in the government, it should be accountable, and mechanisms for citizens to take part in the decision making whenever they think it is fit, it is liable. If you wanted to measure democracies on the basis of this expected outcome, you would look for the following practices and institutions. Regular, free and fair elections should be conducted. So whatever the practices, what practices are they are following in the democracy, so that we get the expected outcome, expected results, right? Nimaga class 10th class ige result barbekandre naave en martivri, revision class martivi, test galna tagota irtivi, nim doubts galna clear ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತೀವಿ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ಹಂಗ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫೇರ್ ಇಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಓಪನ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ದೇ ಡಿಬೇಟ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಪಾಲಿಸೀಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಓಪನ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಡಿಬೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೇಜರ್ ಪಾಲಿಸೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್. Legislations and citizens' right to information about government and its functioning, right? We have to collect the legislations and the citizens' right to information. Citizens' right to information about what? About the government and its functioning. How it is going to function, all these things. The actual performance of democracies shows a mixed record on these. So whatever the actual performance of democracy is there, what it shows the mixed record of this. Democracies have had greater success in setting up regular and free elections. So democracies, what it is having, it is having a greater success. It is doing a greater success in setting up regular and free elections. We are having what type of elections? Regular, and these elections are free elections in setting up conditions for open public debate. So there are conditions where we have seen open public debate is conducted on many of the issues. Raitra bill irbodu, right, on the finance irbodu, on the health and the education, we see that there is a open public debate conducted. But most democracies fall short of elections that provide a fair chance to everyone in subjecting every decision to the public debate. So we cannot put every decision to the public debate. Everything we cannot, every law whichever we are passing, we cannot put it in on the public debate. But there are some serious laws when you are passing it, major laws when you are passing it, that only they are going to put it in the debate. Democratic governments do not have a very good record when it comes to sharing information with the citizens. So democratic governments do not have very good record. There is no very good record when it comes to what? Sharing the information with the citizens. When the sharing of information comes with the citizens, it does not have a good record. In a democratic government, we do not have most of the information about what is happening in the government. government. The people doesn't know, they do not come to know what are the things happening in a government. So this is one drawback. All one can say in favor of democratic regimes is that they are much better than any non-democratic regime in these respects. Yes, compared to non-democratic government, it is good to have a democratic government where people have the freedom, right, to live in whatever way they want. In substantive terms, it may be reasonable to expect from democracy a government that is attentive to the needs and demands of the people and is largely free of corruption. Yes, the most important is the term, whatever the democracy we are telling, whatever the government we are feeling, it should be attentive to what? To the needs and demands of the people, and it should be free from corruption. So in demands, sorry, basically the poor people, what demands they are having? They will be having demanding regarding the first one is the food, then clothing and shelter. These are the basic things which a person needs. Now the basic thing is nowadays it is the employment. What we are expecting from the government, we want to have the employment opportunities, job opportunities. Ik janrige en bekagidare uta bekagilla namage shelter bekagilla en bekagidare ellarigu mena kelasa bekagide. That is what they are demanding to the government. Create the job opportunities in the government. The record of democracies is not impressive on these two accounts. Democracies often frustrate the needs of the people and often ignore the demands of its majority population. So what it is doing? It is ignoring the demands of the population. The routine tales of corruption are enough to convince us that democracy is not free of this evil. So what is happening because of the population? What happens? The tales, the routine tales of corruption are enough to convince us that so you can see here, democracy often frustrates the needs of the people and often ignore the demands of its majority. So it is often ignoring what? The demands of the majority. So what are the demands of the majority population is that we want to have a free corruption country. Right, we don't want to have the corruption in our country. So only we have seen the Prime Minister is doing lot of things he is doing in our country to free India from the corruptions. You can see he has made the income tax department so much active, and he has seen every person now he has to pay the taxes to the government. It has become a mandatory thing. If he has not done so, he will be punished legally by the law. So all these things are done in order to digital India. You are seeing now everything, it is computerized, right, in order to make our country corruption free. The routine tales of corruption are enough to convince us that democracy is not free of this evil. At the same time, there is nothing to show that non-democracies are less corrupt or more sensitive to the people. Here, both the cases of the government, it may be the democratic government or non-democratic government, what we are seeing, there is either it may be the direct way or the indirect way, the corruption is there in the country. Everywhere what we are seeing, there is a corruption. Right, before talking to any government officer, what the person says, sir, yesht bek asht tugand bidri nam kelsa maad kodri. The first way, the first thing the person talks to any person, government official, is the same thing. What he says, sir, enarat tugori maad bidri. So this is the thing happening in the democracy. As well as in the non-democratic government, they are not sensitive towards the people feelings, emotions. They are making them to work like a machines. So that is happening. They are making the people slaves in the country. So that is happening in the non-democratic type of government. There is one respect in which democratic government is certainly better than its alternatives. Democratic government is a legitimate government. Legitimate government means it is a legal government. It may be slow, less efficient, not always very responsive or clean. But a democratic government is people's own government. Yes, always tell you that there is a beauty in the democracy. It is a people's own government where we see that the people decisions are the most important decisions. The people's opinion matter a lot in our country. Right. As the accompanying evidences from South Asia shows, the support exists in the countries with democratic regimes as well as countries without democratic regimes. So there are some instances or there are some examples where you see that there is a democratic regimes are also there and non-democratic regimes are also prevailing in the country. People wish to be ruled by representatives elected by them. Here in a democracy, what we see or what we can think is here the people wish to be ruled by their representatives whom they are electing as the MLAs. They want to be ruled by them, not by the other people. Right, they are going to elect their representatives. They are only are responsible for the electing of the representatives in the country. So you can see here, they can also believe that democracy is suitable for their country. Democracy's ability to generate its own support and is itself an outcome that cannot be ignored. So it is itself an outcome which you cannot ignore in our country. Economic growth and development. If democracies are expected to produce good governments, then is it not fair to accept that they would also produce development? So what here we can see, if the democracies are expected to what? To produce good government. If the government and democracies has to produce the good government, then it is not fair to expect that they would also produce and development. They would go for the development only. Evidences shows that in the practice, many democracy did not fulfill this expectation. So economic growth doesn't means that there is development. Economic growth doesn't means that there is a democracy in the country. Democracy always does not say that there will be an increase in the economic growth rate. There will be an increase in the development. These are all the different things. If you consider all democracies and all dictatorships for 50 years between 1950 and 2000, dictatorships have slightly higher rate of economic growth. So dictatorship form of government or non-democratic form of government are having what? More economic growth rate than compared to the democratic form of government. The inability of democracy to achieve higher economic development worries us. So democracy, because of democracy, we are unable to achieve the higher economic growth rate. The inability of the democracy to achieve higher economic development worries us, but this alone cannot be reason to reject democracy. As you have already studied in economics, economic development depends on several factors: country's population size, global situation, cooperation from other countries, economic priorities adopted by the country, etc. So I have told you, in order to have the economic development, economic growth, what is important? The number of population is important. If the population decreases, then automatically what happens? Economic growth rate increases. When economic growth rate increases, the income of the individuals, income of the population increases. When income of the population increases, the development increases in our country. So most important is the population growth. But is it decreasing in our country? No, not at all. We have 130 crores of population. ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಒಂದು ಮನೆಯಾಗ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಜನ ಒಬ್ಬ ದುಡಿಯವ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಮಂದಿ ತಿನ್ನೋರಿದ್ರೆ ಹೆಂಗೋ ಮನೆ ನಡೆಸ್ಬೋದ್ರಿ. ಒಂದು ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿನಾಗ 10 ಮಂದಿ ಒಬ್ಬ ದುಡಿಯಾಮಿದ್ರೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ಹೌ ದ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ 9 ಪೀಪಲ್. 9 ಜನ ಕೂತು ತಿಂತಾರಂದ್ರೆ ಡ್ಯೂ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ದ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರೆಸ್, ದ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರೆಸ್? ನೋ, ನಾಟ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್. ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್, ರೈಟ್? When the population is decreasing, the production of goods and services will increase, right? When the production of goods and services are increasing, profit is increasing. When profit is increasing, economic growth rate is increasing. When economic growth rate is increasing, automatically it leads to the development. When we find such a significant difference in the rates of economic growth between the countries under dictatorship and democracy, it is better to prefer democracy as it has several positive outcomes. So it is better we go with the growth between the countries under the dictatorship and democracy. It is better to prefer democracy because it has lot of positive outcomes. See here, you can see economic growth and distribution gains. So rich, right? They are getting the more things, more the middle, only less things. And the poor, almost all nil. They are getting the things. So let us see what are the economic outcomes of the democracy. Arguments about a democracy tend to be very passionate. This is how it should be. For democracy appeals some of our deep values. So democracy, how is it appealing? It is appealing some of our deep values. These debates cannot be resolved in a simple manner, but some debates about democracy can and should be resolved by referring to some facts and figures. The debate about the economic outcomes of democracy is one such debate. Over years, many students of democracy have gathered careful evidence to see what the relationship of democracy with economic growth and economic inequalities is. So over the years, many students of democracy have gathered, and they have gathered what? Careful evidences they have gathered about what the relationship of democracy is with the economic growth and economic inequalities. Let us see. Table 1 shows that on an average, dictatorial regimes have had a slightly better record of economic growth, but when compared to their record in only in poor countries, there is virtually no difference. So here you can see what are necessary, right? What are the necessary things in the democracy? Let us see. My goodness, little fella, how far did you fall down? You tell me. So where we are falling down, right? That is the housing, healthcare, schooling, hunger. These are the basic things which an individual should have. Housing facility, right? Shelter, healthcare facilities should be provided to all the people. Schooling facility, education should be given to each and every child. Next one is hunger. People should not die of hunger. Poverty should not be there in our country. So these four are the things which everyone, every citizen of our country, if he is satisfied with all these things, if he is provided with all these four facilities, then definitely India will become a developed country. So these are the four facilities which should be given by the government so that the poor man can survive in our country. So here you can see reduction in inequality, reduction of inequality and the poverty. Let us go here. Perhaps more than the development, it is reasonable to accept democracies to reduce economic disparities. So economic disparities means economic difference between the people. See here, if you are born as a poor, if you die as a poor, then there is no value of your life. When you are born as a poor, it is not your mistake. But again, if you are dying as a poor, then definitely it is the mistake of you. You have to do something so that you achieve the high things in the life. No person know all. If you see the rich people, by born they are not rich. By struggling in their life, by doing lot of struggles, they have achieved that place. So it depends on you, how do you overcome these weaknesses and how you convert it into the strengths. So economic differences are there everywhere in the whole world, it is there, but it is in our hands to increase the income of our family. When the income of the family increases, the standard of living increases, then automatically what happens? People purchase more goods and services. Then automatically the production of the goods and services increases, the profit increases. Then what happens? Ultimately, you are going to go have for a good economic growth rate. Even when a country achieves economic growth, will have wealth be distributed in such a way that all citizens of the country will have share and lead a better life? Is economic growth in democracies accompanied by increased inequalities among the people? Yes. Even though we get the whatever the money we have earned, it is only for the use of ourselves and for the our family. We are not going to distribute it to any of the persons of the family with the country. We are not going to distribute. But what we are doing, we are paying the taxes to the government. By that collection of taxes, definitely what will happen, we can say that there will be the growth rate in the economy. New Srimant Ragiri, you can see the one sugar factory owner, what he does. He gives employment for 1000 employees. After that, he removes the schools. He gives at least 200 employment for teachers, drivers, peons, IMRs and all. So again, 200 people he is giving the employment opportunities. So like that, by becoming rich, he goes on expanding his business. And what happens? He goes on giving the employment opportunities also. This is necessary in our country. Right? Or do democracies lead to just a distribution of goods and opportunities? No, it is not like that. It is definitely going to be helpful in order to eradicate the poverty from India. Democracies are based on political equality. All individuals have equal weight in electing representatives. Yes, every individual has one vote, one value. Whether you may be from any caste, if you are above the age of 18 years, you have the right to vote. One vote, one value. For one vote, there is only one value, and it is equal for all the caste, creed, religions, regions. For everyone, it is the same rule. Parallel to the process of bringing individuals in the political area on an equal footing, we find growing economic inequalities. A small number of ultra rich enjoy a highly disproportionate share of wealth and income. So here in India, what is happening? Only some persons are enjoying the higher incomes, higher share of the wealth. But it is not so. It should not happen. Everyone in our country must enjoy equal share of the wealth as well as the profit income in the nation. But it is not happening so. Not only that, their share in the total income of the country has been increasing. Yes, what is increasing? Their share in the total income of the country is also increasing. Here, what is happening? In the simple ways, I will tell you, rich is becoming more and more rich, poor is becoming poor and poor. That is happening in India. Their incomes have been declining. Sometimes they find it difficult to meet their basic needs of life, such as food, clothing, house, education, and health. So what happens in sometimes the people are below the poverty line, where they are not able to get the food, 2 square meals a day. They are unable to get it. They suffer from the hunger. They suffer from not having the clothes. They suffer from not having the houses, not having the education, not not getting the good health care facilities for themselves. So this is the things, these are the things which are happening in India. Okay, children, thank you. Further things I will continue in the next class.